scene. So this is a set I'm using. It's a German set, but all the German set you see me using are always available in English. So this set is an English glowing seaside from Greater Smile. So I prepared some a card base in this longer size and a matching card panel with my hexacompter paper in this long side. I thought it's a good idea to make an underwater scene and with very deep water. So I use these two stencils. The first one is on the top is a self-made stencil, just with a dye and some stable foil. And the second one, I am not sure from which company, so I'm so sorry. But I think there are a lot of companies who have whatever these kind of stencils. And I'm using distress oxides in this case. If you're asking when I'm using oxides or the normal distress inks, it depends on what I'm doing. So when I'm planning to fill the whole card with color, then I use the oxides. But when I just want to, for example, color in the bottom part of a card and want to fade out the color to white, then I think these oxides are not easy to handle, except you have kind of brush. So in this case, I use a normal distress ink. So I use my sun burns. What is the word? Sun. I have forgot the word. A stencil, and I colored in with the first color in this broken china, and then I put my stencil away and put broken china again on it because I want to have these. I don't know the word. I look for the word, sorry. Okay, sunbeams, not sunburns. Sunburns is a little bit different thing. So I wanted these sunbeams, not so obviously, or not so, I wanted to have them a little bit smoother. Yes, and I also use the color Salty Ocean in the middle of the card. And at the bottom I used Faded Jeans. Did I say it in the right direction? Broken China, Salty Ocean, Faded Jeans. So, and the happiest thing about these distress inks, no matter if you're using the normals or the oxides, if you work not so clean, everything is forgiven when you put on these water drops. So then nobody sees any mistakes anymore. So, and it's a great effect also that you have these water drops on your card. So that is what I'm doing now. I just take my water drops out of these kind of spray bottles. It's the best way for me because I, in this technique, I have a lot of water drops. And then I dry it with a tissue until everything is dried. And yes, and the second step, I took some white color from my Kurotake box. And but I think it could be a better option to buy soon a kind of white liquid color or cream color from a tube, because these white drops are, when they are dried, you cannot see them so good anymore. It's a little bit sad, but it's okay. I like my underwater scene till now. Now I come to the coloring of these little images. First I have to look for the English word. Oh no, it's a jellyfish, I remember from my last video. But even in German, I have no idea what the name of the right one guy is. So if you know how it's called, please leave me a comment so I can learn more about our water animals. Thank you for that. So I use Copics. I have no idea why I think these. In this case, I wanted to have these bright colors for the bright colored background. And I took these R Copics, and in this case, yes, I put these numbers in the video. It's a service I do not give you so often, I'm sorry for that. But in this case, I thought about it. So I colored the shadow on the top of the jellyfish. I think it was not such a good idea because the sun is coming from this side. So this jellyfish should have been light on the top and dark at the bottom. I have no idea why I did this. Maybe because of these tiny dots came from this stamp image. So maybe I thought this should be the darker part. So that is why I put my darkest Copics on this place. I'm sorry for that. And if you're wondering why my hands hold still some seconds for a while, it's my iPad. I watched a series while coloring, and sometimes it was so... Wait. Yeah, sometimes it was so exciting that I hold still for some seconds. I'm sorry for that. Yes, I used the same colors. Because I'm not so good in mixing colors, because I have the blue from the underwater scene, and now I have this kind of light pink, or is it peachy pink? And I was afraid that when I use a third color, I will do not like the result, because I'm a little bit crazy in this case. Sorry. I'm also not able to mix patterns, so yes, it's my dark side. So, but now we are almost finished. I just try to make these. Here's a break and another break. It was so excited. And yes, I forgot what I wanted to say, but I think it was not the importance. Things. So I hope I come to the end now with coloring. When I made the voiceover for the German video, I knew that I will have struggles with talking all these colorings in English. But yeah, it's over. So now at the end, I just do some accents with my or special effects, like in a special movie, with my gel pen. I like it very much. And I think I use it on nearly every image I colored with Copics. So, and then I thought maybe these two images are not enough. Should I add a third one? And I struggled with this case. But then I choose a very big sentiment. And I think with the sentiment it is okay with these two lonely critters. So, for embossing my sentiment, I make sure that my paper is dried well, and then I put a lot of these anti-static powder on it, and I use my brush for it because my powder tool, it's broken again. So, I use my Misty for stamping, and even if I stamped it twice with my Versamark, the result is not so good. I think maybe I did not have enough pressure for my hands on the Misty. So when I put my white embossing powder on it, I've seen that the result is not the best. Then I was a little bit sad, cried in my tissue. But then I had an idea how I can fix it. But first you have to watch me heat emboss whatever it. So here's my great trick. I have this watermark pen. I think this is perfect for lettering, and lettering with embossing, of course. But my lettering skills are nearly not available, not here. So I have no skills. But to fix these little spots, is it great? You see the fixed parts? Wait. You see the parts above all, love my translator, now that you see that I made a fault. But I think in the end, the result is quite okay. The alternative would have been to make the whole card again, and no, I didn't want to do this. So I did this little fixing, and I was quite happy with the result. So here's my last little fixie. And now I finished my embossing. This is this pen, and I like him very much. I had a Shiba pen before, and I didn't like these results. So I just added German sentiment, and the whole sentiment means don't worry that you are older or something like that. And as I told you, also this set is available in Don't Worry. So in German it's Keine Sorge, and you can stamp Don't Worry. None of my corner jumpers coming. I like it very much when I make these long cards. I don't know why. Maybe that they do not look so static, maybe. I like to jump my corners or round my corners with a jumper or whatever. So I add these images, and I think, okay, I could have done more images or some underwater flowers or things like that. But I think it's enough. I thought about doing some clouds or something in the air, but for this I had no idea. So, in Germany you say you should end when it's best. So this is what I did. Yes, I put it on my very long card. And to give this card a little finish, I always put some Nouveau Drops or sequins on it. In this case, I used these white Nouveau Drops. It's kind of underwater bubbles, also breathing bubbles from these unknown animals. Yes, so I'm happy that I, to the end of this English voiceover, I'm so sorry for my stupid English. I hope you take it funny, whatever. Yes, thank you so much for watching, and have a wonderful day. And I wave bye-bye.